Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to start a new series on Power Apps with an introduction to how to use the Power Apps application. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So to access Power Apps, we're going to start by going to office.com and going up here to the app launcher. If you've used Power Apps before, you'll see it in this list right here. If it doesn't appear on this list, you can go down to All Apps, scroll down to the P's, and select Power Apps right here. And then the Power Apps application will be launched. But what is Power Apps? Power Apps is a way to create really quick apps for a phone or a PC without knowing any kind of programming. So first of all, before we start this, I want to go out to OneDrive and show you a data source that we're going to be working with. So down here on OneDrive, I have a spreadsheet called Recipes. I'm going to click on that so you can see what it looks like. So inside my spreadsheet, I have a category for each of my recipes, the name of my recipe, and then the instructions for each recipe. Now, one thing that's really important for Power Apps is that inside my spreadsheet, I have my data formatted in a table format. If you don't know how to do that, basically just select all of your data and go up here to Insert and make sure you've selected Table, and then your data will be in a recognizable format for Power Apps. So let's close out of here and go back to Power Apps. So once inside of Power Apps, I'm going to go over here to Create, and I'm going to create an app starting from an Excel file. So if I click right here, I will be prompted for the location of my Excel file. Now I'm going to go out to my OneDrive for Business because that's where the file is that I just showed you. And I'm going to choose the recipes file that I just showed you. And right here, you can see that I'm being asked for what table is my data in, and I'm going to select table 1. And then I'm going to hit connect. And now Power Apps has taken my data source and it's created an initial app where I can start, and then I can just customize this app to be what I want it to look like for the final product. So if I go up here to this play button, I can get an idea of how the app functions based on the app that Power Apps just created. So I'm going to go up here to the search and I'm going to type in salad. And I can see that anything with the word salad has automatically already been brought up. So if I click on one of these recipes, I can see that I've been taken to my recipe, and I can see the name of my recipe, the instructions for my recipe, and the category that it falls in. If I go up here to the pencil, I could edit this. And when I was done editing, I can hit the checkbox, or I can hit the X here to cancel my changes. So let's hit the X. And then I can also delete this entry as well, if I don't want this to appear in my recipe list anymore. So if I hit the back button, I also have some other options at the top. I can hit this button to refresh my list in case more items have been added to my recipe list, or I could sort this in alphabetical order, or I could come here and I can create a new item. So if I click here, let's do a category. Let's just call this AAA so it sorts to the top, and let's just call this test recipe. And let's call this test instructions and hit the check mark. So if I scroll all the way to the top again and I take off my search criteria, you can see the test recipe that I have just entered. If I click the arrow again here and hit delete, I'll be taken back to the main screen and you can see that that top entry has now been deleted. So this is a functioning app right now. And maybe you like the app just the way it came out and you would just be willing to leave it this way. But I do want to show you that you can edit certain parts of this app and you can add functionality all without knowing how to code. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So I'm going to go over here and hit the X. And you can now see my tree view of the design that Power Apps automatically created. So let's go over a few things. I'm going to close this tree and you can see a few different screens. The browse screen, which is this main screen right here. The detail screen that you saw when we viewed the recipe, and the edit screen where we could edit the recipe. So let's go to the detail screen and just give you some options for what's available to you. If I click this arrow to expand this section, you can see a few different things. I have a detail form, which is the screen right here. And on that form, I have some data fields. First, I have the recipe data field. Then I have the instructions, and then I have the category. But I also have a few things down here too. I have the delete icon, I have the edit icon, and I have the back arrow icon right here. And say I go over here to the app name, and if I look over here at the properties, see how it says table one up here? Let's change this to say recipe details. And you can see over here, I can change the font size and I can change the style and the text alignment, etc. So I have a lot of options to change the look of my app. But for now, I just want that to say recipe details. Let's also say that I would like to change the order that these fields are appearing. I'm going to scroll up and go to detail form. And then see where it says fields over here? I'm going to click edit fields. And these are each one of my fields that I have on this form. So let's say I would like the recipe name to be at the top. I'm just going to click and drag that to the top. And then the instructions, and then the category. You can see that I've now rearranged how this looks. So I'm going to click the X here, and now I can see that I have edited this page further. And let me show you something else. If I click on this delete button here, and you can see the code up here for the delete button, and it looks like this. We are going to remove from table one, which is the table in our Excel spreadsheet, the selected item. If I click on edit over here, you can see the code up here. We're going to edit this item, and we're going to do that through edit screen one, that if I scroll down, you can see is right here. So that's saying that we're going to store the value of the item that we are on, and then we're going to navigate to edit screen one. And right here, the back arrow, you can see that we're going to navigate to browse screen one. And if I scroll up, browse screen one is the original screen that has all of our recipes listed. So now if I want to test my app with these changes, I can hit the play button up here. And I'm going to go back to the recipe details. And I'm going to just select this recipe right here for fruit, salsa, and chips. Now you can see the recipe name is at the top, the instructions are next, and then it's the category. And you can also see that I've changed recipe details here. Remember, if I hit the edit button, I'm going to navigate to this screen, and I can either reject or accept my changes. For now, I'm going to reject them, and then I'm going to navigate back to the main screen. So then I'm going to hit the X up here, and if I scroll down to the edit screen one, you can see that there's a few things to change on here as well. I'm going to click table one and go over here to my text and say edit recipe. And then again, I'm just going to show you what a few of these buttons do. If I click the check mark, I'm going to submit my changes. And if I hit the X, I'm going to reset my form first, and then I'm going to go back to the previous screen. If you need to write some of these functions up here yourself because you're starting an app from scratch, you can go up here to the F of X, and you can pick a whole bunch of different functions in here. And if you need to know more about any of these functions in here, you can hit this Learn More link right here, and that will take you to an alphabetized list of the functions on Microsoft's site where you can see what each one of these commands is doing. Okay, so once your app is done, if you want to share this app with someone, You can hit the back button and save your changes. And then you can save a version of this app. So let's just call this recipes and hit save. So when I'm done with my app, I can come over here to the publish button and you can see that I can publish this version of the app. So I'm going to go ahead and publish that. And then I'm going to go up here and hit the share button. And I will be asked who I want to share this app with. And up here, you can type in the email of anyone in your organization with whom you would like to share this app. And then you can hit the share button down here. I can also come back to the app details screen and I can see more ways I can share this. I can add it to Teams. I can export it as a package. I can hit the share button to share, but I can also take this link right here and copy it. And if I paste it in a new tab, you can see that I can actually see the app and I can use the app on screen and I can search and I can see all of my recipes in here. So hopefully this gives you a quick introduction to some of the possibilities inside of Power Apps. We will be doing more videos on this in the upcoming weeks, so be on the lookout for those. If you have any comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.